Ladies and gentlemen,
the DuMont Television Network presents the Chicago Symphony Orchestra. How do you do, ladies and gentlemen? My name is Francis Coffin, speaking from Chicago. You are very welcome this evening to join us in hearing the ninth telecast concert of the present series by the world-famous Chicago Symphony Orchestra, founded by Theodore Thomas in 1891, the third oldest symphony in America, and one of the truly distinguished orchestras in the world. Tonight, the Chicago Symphony Orchestra is directed by Vladimir Golschmann, the distinguished conductor of the St. Louis Symphony. And we are to hear music, an interesting historical program of music from the 17th and 18th centuries. Music by Haydn, music by Mozart, and music by the 17th century composers, Corelli, Vivaldi, and Rameau. An extremely interesting program, and as we await now the signal which will direct Mr. Golschmann to conduct from the podium, may we tell you that the overture is Mozart's delightful overture to the marriage of Figaro, a gay, a graceful, and appealing overture, one of the most beautiful overtures ever written. Mozart's Overture to the Marriage of Figaro, performed by the Chicago Symphony Orchestra, this evening directed by Vladimir Golschmann. We're to hear next by Arcangelo Corelli, a brilliant work of Italian origin, dating from the 17th century. It is called Adagio, and Corelli was one of the first and one of the very greatest of that fine race of Italian fiddlers who did so much to improvise upon the instrument, to realize the scope of the instrument, to produce beautiful music. Corelli's Adagio. Vladimir Golschmann, directing the Chicago Symphony Orchestra. He's this evening's guest conductor. And we have heard Corelli's Adagio. We're to hear next another work of the 17th century, an Italian work, by Vivaldi, Antonio Vivaldi. Vivaldi was a Venetian, a priest, wrote mostly ecclesiastical music, but wrote a great number of works for the violin. He was honored in having Bach, who was 5 years younger than himself, choose many of his motifs for further development. This by Antonio Vivaldi, the Concerto Grosso. ¶¶ Antonio Vivaldi's Concerto for Orchestra No. 11, Opus 3 in D major. The applause, of course, for the Chicago Symphony Orchestra, for Vladimir Golschmann, this evening's distinguished guest conductor. Thinking of the music we're hearing this evening, and thinking of the time in which it was written, we have heard three works of the 17th century. Rather, we've heard two, and we should hear a third. The Corelli, the Vivaldi, and following this brief intermission talk, movements from the Dardanus suite by Jean-Philippe Rameau. Corelli is the oldest of the composers heard this evening. He was born in 1653. It's interesting to note that this excellent music was written while John Alden was still alive on the hardscrabble shores of Plymouth Colony in New England. Vivaldi, as I've said, was a priest. His father, a distinguished violinist, the Venetian, and due to the construction of St. Mark's Cathedral in Venice, a construction which permitted the use of antiphonal choirs, of answering choirs, and a musical practice which grew out of that, rather at variance with the more accepted practice in Rome, Vivaldi and Venetian composers were able to initiate new and daring and extremely interesting works. Vivaldi's music interested Bach, as I've said, and he was an extremely industrious composer. The work we have just heard was written originally for two violins and a cello as against a string orchestra, and the arrangement in which we've heard it, of course, the woodwinds have been added. Musicians of the 17th century and of the early 18th century were, for the most part, servants in standing. They were attendants upon the great houses, the noble houses, whether ecclesiastic or lay noblemen. They took their meals with the servants. They were part of a nobleman's pomp and ostentation. They almost had to have a connection with the church, because the church was a great employer of music, and churchmen themselves were very able musicians. Corelli's two principal sponsors were cardinals in Rome. They recognized genius, and they treated it as such, but until Beethoven's time and after, always with the hauteur of the true nobleman. Vivaldi, then, the priest, Corelli, a brilliant young fiddler who originated much of the modern violin technique and who wrote his own music because there was no other music to play, and Rameau, a composer to the French court of Louis XV. Rameau began as a strolling minstrel, a traveling musician. He played organ for a while. He made a very fortunate impression upon one of Louis's numerous mistresses, and he found himself directeur du cabinet, composing music for the king. He composed ballet, opera, did very beautifully with it, established in France what the Italians were establishing in Italy, a classical school, school noted for grace, refinement, extreme brilliance, and very, very careful musicianship. All later musicians built upon the techniques discovered and the methods worked out by the earlier composers. So we come to the finale, to anticipate a little, to Franz Joseph Papa Haydn, Symphony No. 88. And Haydn was born in 1732. He lived also under the shadow of the nobility. For 30 years, he was a house musician to the princely house of Esterházy in Hungary. He was hardly a modern man. He was a man who believed in the duty of the commons toward the nobility. He was a very simple man in the nice sense. He didn't question the postulates of his world. He was an expert musician, tremendously industrious, tremendously capable. And Mr. Golschmann is again on the podium waiting the signal from the camera director. Excuse me, we're here. Jean-Philippe Rameau's music from the Dardanus suite. In this particular arrangement, it's heard in three movements, the rondo, the rigadoon, and the entree. It was written, first performed in 1739, very early, music of the French court, music of the formal mask, music of the formal and stately, and we should say extremely boresome opera. but music beautifully done for experts.
Thank you.
Rameau's Dardanus Suite, performed as a rondo, a brigadoon, and an entree by the Chicago Symphony Orchestra, Vladimir Golschmann, the guest conductor. I was speaking a moment ago of Franz Joseph Haydn, whose Symphony No. 88 in G major is to bring to a close the present performance. He was born, as I've said, in 1732. He served 60 years with the Esterházys. He became a noted composer, famous in England and in France, but he remained essentially the peasant genius, the servant type. And his music brings to a point the classical culture of old Vienna.
Thank you.
Franz Joseph Haydn, Symphony No. 88, in I believe it is G major, performed this evening by the Chicago Symphony Orchestra under the direction of Vladimir Golschmann, himself the distinguished conductor of the St. Louis Symphony, one of the great guest conductors to be heard with the Chicago Symphony during these concerts of the present season. We have heard this evening an unusually interesting program of music of the 17th and 18th centuries. We have heard music by Mozart, Corelli, Vivaldi, Rameau, and Haydn. It is formal music. It is music, the development of which lies at the base of the musical art as we know it. Not only fascinating and interesting in itself, in its workmanship, in its technique, in its scope, but also interesting as the origin of so much that we know as music. Almost no present music could have been written did not the great pioneers, the inventors, the artists, conceive and execute this music first. Here I think I should, I do find most appropriate, Haydn's remark when he was chided, being a simple man, an untraveled man, at not speaking other languages than German, than his native Viennese. And Haydn said, but my language is music, and music is understood everywhere. The Chicago Symphony Orchestra will be heard next week. I'll glance at the program here since there have been some changes. Desiree Defoe will be the guest conductor, himself a former conductor of the Great Chicago Symphony. His appearance on the podium here will be most welcome. Under Mr. Defoe, we shall hear readings of Gretry's ballet suite, Cephalia Procris. We shall hear readings from Fauré's operatic suite, Pelléas et Mélisande, that is Fauré's arrangement from Pelléas and Mélisande. And we shall hear Robert Alexander Schumann's Great Romantic Symphony No. 4. These concerts by the Chicago Symphony Orchestra come to you in a full hour-long series. They are intended to bring you excellent music for balanced listening, music of historical, of current, of national and international importance. We shall hear, during the weeks to come, superb guest conductors who will be with the Great Chicago Symphony, and we shall hear music always in the Chicago Symphony's tradition of great music gloriously played. The Chicago Symphony Orchestra is a DuMont Television Network production in association with Television Air Shows Incorporated. This DuMont production originates in the studios of WGN Chicago. This is the DuMont Television Network. Francis Coughlin speaking. Good evening.